Dear students, before going to the first B program, which is the YAC program, let me give you the introduction about the YAC. So YAC stands for Yet Another Compiler Compiler. Yet Another Compiler Compiler. So what it is? It is a tool which generates LLR parser. That means LLR, it is kind of a syntax analyzer parser. Okay, so YAC is a tool which generates a syntax analyzer called LALR parser. So what is syntax analyzer? It is the second phase of compiler which take input as token and generate the syntax T. The first phase of the compiler is the lexical analyzer, which is generated by the lex program. This is second phase of the compiler is the syntax analyzer, which is generated by the YAC, yet another compiler compiler parser. So it takes the input and it generates a syntax tree. It will be clear in the next few slides. Next is this is the structure, how the program executes. If you write any YAC program, it should be extended, the file name should be extended with .y. The file name should be extended with .y. Now, if we feed up to the YAC compiler, it will generate a .c file called y.tab.c. y.tab.c. Again, this y.tab.c will be compiled by C compiler and it will give you the a.out. So this is only called the syntax analyzer. So now we have got our syntax analyzer a.out. In this syntax analyzer, whatever input we will enter, it will generate the parse tree, syntax tree. That is the output it will generate. Let us see next. Now suppose for example, let us consider that we have generated a YAC program with extension .y. So gram.y. Now we can compile this with YAC. Now it will generate a file, C file called y.tab.c. And this y.tab.c file will be compiled by the CC or GCC compiler. Then it will generate the syntax analyzer a.out, executable program that will parse grammar given in the gram.y. Now it is a syntax analyzer has generated, and whatever input you give, based on that it will create a syntax tree. Next, let us see the structure. So this also has the three parts: definition part, rule part, and supplementary code. And all the three sections will be separated by two double percentage. Next, percentage. Let us see what all things are there in the definition, rules, and supplementary code. In the definition section, all code between percentage and percentage is copied to C file. So whatever we write in the definition section, that will be copied to the C file. C file that we generate, so y.tab.c. y.tab.c. So all the code will be copied in the C file. The definition section is where we configure various parser features such as defining token codes, establishing operator precedence, associativity, and setting up variables used to communicate between the scanner and the parser. So in this section, we can define tokens, we can establish operator precedence, means among, plus, minus, into, division, which operator will be executed first. We can also set up the associativity, that left associativity or right associativity, and which can communicate between the scanner and the parser. So this is what happens in the definition section. Third section, second section is the rule section. So the required production section is where we specify the grammar rules. So all the grammar rules will be specified in the rule section. Third section is the supplementary code section. It is used for ordinary C code that we want copied verbatim to the generated C file. Declaration are copied to the top of the file user. So it is a C code which will be used to give the output based on the syntax. So let us start the 1V program, that is write a YAC program to evaluate arithmetic expression involving operator plus, minus, into, and divide. We have to evaluate an arithmetic expression which includes the operators plus, minus, into, and division.